You know, Romel, Anthony Bourdain's work shed a lot of light on international cuisine. Now his death is shedding light on a very important topic. And joining us now here at the TFC headquarters in Daly City, California, is Hazel Benigno, Program Director and Licensed Clinical Psychologist with Star Vista. She will help us make sense of suicide and the factors that could lead a person to do this tragic act. Dr. Benigno, thank you for joining us. You know, the suicides this week of high-profile personalities, designer Kate Spade, and now celebrity chef Anthony Bourdain, they remind us that no matter, you know, how seemingly successful, wealthy, or happy individuals are, there are individual demons. Are there any warning signs when it comes to someone who might be prone to attempt or commit suicide?
Well, yes and no. There are some more typical warning signs, especially when someone isn't acting like their usual self. So they may become a little more isolated and withdrawn. They may start giving away prized possessions, or they may even start kind of talking about things happening in coming weeks or coming months as if they're not there anymore. The trouble with this, though, is that everybody kind of reacts a little differently. And so sometimes we may not even get any warning signs at all. And the best way to really respond is to be proactive and to reach out to our loved ones and check in with them. You know, ask them, hey, is everything okay? I noticed you haven't been your usual self. Do you want to talk? I'm here for you. And something like that can really go a long way with someone.
That's very true. And that can go a long way.
Absolutely. Doctor, are people who are more famous and successful, I mean, like Bourdain, like Kurt Cobain, like Robin Williams, are they more prone to suicide?
Well, it's kind of difficult because, for one thing, we all measure success in very different ways. So we may look at someone who's more well-known in their field and who may be wealthy and think that they're successful. But to them, success may be a little more simple. It may be that they have great connections with the people they care about, that they're fulfilled and feel at peace when they go home. So it's always hard to say that just because someone looks like they're successful that they are and that everything is okay with them. That said, I do see the merit in kind of asking about people who are more in high profile and high pressure situations, because they're really expected to be on all the time and they're expected to be successful no matter what and not need help from anyone, which is why it makes it difficult for them to reach out for help. That mm-hmm. and the added stigma of seeking mental health services as it is, which is again why you know, community members and loved ones are really important and really vital to this process.
Very important. Doctor, one quick last question. There is an audience around who sees, you know, these tragic events. How does this impact their fans? How does this impact, you know, the general public?
Well, I think if anything, this has kind of continued the conversation about mental health and suicide for a while. I mean, statistics show that for folks who attempt or even think about suicide, that about 90% of them are struggling through some kind of mental illness. That said, just because somebody is working through their own mental health issues, that doesn't necessarily mean that this is their fate and this is what is destined to happen. Mm-hmm. This is why we encourage folks to utilize your resources, reach out to community members, practice your spirituality, because especially in the Filipino community, those things are so important to us. Mm-hmm. But sometimes they're not always ready to talk with us. And so in those cases, reaching out to professionals for help or even reaching out to hotlines for help, those can really make a big difference as well.
Well, thank you very much, Dr. Benigno. I know it's a difficult topic, but thank you for shedding some light on this. And we would also like to reiterate, if you or someone you know is depressed or suicidal, please call the Suicide Prevention Lifeline at 1-800-273-8255, or please visit the website suicidepreventionlifeline.org.